Hello viewers, this is Muniba Faiza from Bioinformatics Review. Today we are going to perform virtual screening using Autodoc Mina. We will follow this pre-written article published in Bioinformatics Review, how to perform virtual screening using Autodoc Mina. So here we have described, you can either use Perl script or Bash script for virtual screening. And you will have to prepare the receptor file and the ligand files individually into the PDBQT format using Autodoc tools. And we are using the same files for docking. The receptor will be CMPF, the PDB ID is 2BXA, and the ligands are acetylcholine, naphthalene, sodium octanoate, sodium salicylate, and thymol acetate. So these are the five ligands we are going to dock with the same receptor, that is 2BXA.PDB. As you can see, I have already prepared the PDBQT file. If you want to know how did I prepare them, so simply follow this tutorial. How to perform docking in a specific binding site using Autodoc Mina. And here I have described all the binding residues of this receptor as well. You can see them here. Yeah, these are the five binding residues which I have used to define pocket for this protein, and these are the XYZ coordinates, and this is my yes. And now you have to prepare a config file which is a little different from the normal configuration file which you use for docking. Here you don't have to mention the ligand name, and you don't have to mention the vena log output file name and the vena output you will be getting. So you don't have to specify them in this file. So this is a simple config file. You can always download it from our GitHub repository. Here it is conf_vs.txt. And since we are performing on Ubuntu, so we will use this vena virtual screening linux.pl Perl script. And I have already downloaded this file as well. Here you can see this is the file. Yes, and for virtual screening you have to prepare the ligands in the format of PDBQT by yourself, and as I have prepared them here using Autodoc tools. It's quite simple. You first download from PubChem the 3D conformer in the .sdf format, convert them into PDB using PyMol. I have already shown in my previous video tutorials, and then convert into .pdbqt format using ADT. So we have prepared ligands, we have prepared the receptor, we have the config file. Now we just need to specify the ligand names into a separate file. Here I have created this file ligands. This file consists of all the ligands which I have prepared for virtual screening, and just you don't have to write anything else but the names of the ligands with the .pdbqt extension. Just remember this. So just simply open the terminal and type Perl space vena this here. Now it is asking for the file name of ligands list, and this is simple ligands here. So it will finish all the ligands one by one, and you will just have to wait till it finishes. Okay, now it's done. You can see here in the folder there is one log output file showing all the binding affinities of all the poses, and here is the your output file which you can analyze in PyMol. Open the protein to bxa.pdb and open the output file here. Let's say it's this. No, it's not. Yes, it's out.pdbqt. Open and go through the same steps. Okay. Or if you want to set it for Okay, so as you can see, it is showing interactions. If you want to know how to analyze results in full details, you can follow other tutorials as well. I have also posted one video tutorial on Veena output analysis, and there are several articles using Discovery Studio also. So that's all about the virtual screening. If you have any query, you can always email me at muniba@bioinformaticsreview.com, and you can always visit our website for more articles regarding bioinformatics, or you can also like our Facebook page to keep yourself updated. And I would like to invite you to become a premium member of Bioinformatics Review, either by taking a premium membership. You can also support us on Patreon to get some premium and exclusive membership perks. Thanks for watching.